Let's go!
What's up, y'all? It's your boy Super Barber Samson with another banger video. Drake, this haircut, I'm looking at the haircut. Drake, you make too much money to have a deformed heart. Come on, boy. I need to holler at your barber, all right? Here we go.
Yeah, Drake! Drake? The nigga that got bitey by Pusha T? The nigga that's hiding his kid from the world, but his world wouldn't hide from the kid? Arby Graham in a wheelchair? Drake!
Yes!
Y'all niggas better stop playing with me in here. Y'all talking about the light-skinned nigga from DeGeneres?
Degrassi.
Stop playing me like I ain't teach Drake everything he know.
Hold on, you taught Drake everything he know.
Y'all didn't hear Drake on with his first song? Tell me what's really going on. Drizzy Drake back in this thing already. What's really going on. Drizzy Drake back in this thing already. That's Soulja.
What's really going on? Soulja boy up in this thing already. What's happening?
Tell me what's really going on. Drizzy back up in this thing. I'm ready. What's happening?
He copy my whole.
What's up, y'all? I just went to show a couple of photos of the different hearts that Drake had in his head. And I mean, like, come on now. When you make as much money as Drake, you need to have the best looking heart in the world. So I got my young boy. He's a Drake fan. One of my young clients. And him and his mom came in, and she's excited that he wants his haircut lower. And so, he showed me the haircut that he wanted, and I wasn't disappointed, but I was like, okay, if you want this Drake haircut, you sure? He was like, yes, me and my dad is gonna rock out with Drake haircut, so we're gonna have the same haircut, so I'm gonna rock out. I want the same haircut, I want the heart. And I told him, I was like, I'm gonna make your haircut look better than Drake's haircut. I was like, bet. He was like, bet, let's go. So this video is literally talking about how, the industry, we have barbers in the industry. So this is why I always talking about support the culture. So it's not really to down or shoot down Drake's barber. It's not to shoot down any barber, actually, because I really want every barber to win. But I will say this. I have so many friends who are barbers, not just in the industry. I'm talking about in the music industry. I myself was a barber in the music industry, hip hop industry, cut a lot of rappers' hair. Currently, I'm cutting people hair who are in the industry. And I just personally feel like someone who is literally in the eye of its crowd, you know, social media, TV, videos, this, that, and the third, I really believe that you should actually own your skills, up your skills, and take your skills to the next level. Now, I know I'll probably get a lot of people say, well, this is the barber. Like, I already know who the barber who's cutting his hair. I'm not going to mention his name because I'm not here to shoot barbers down. But what I am here to say is that, no, every haircut is not perfect. I agree. But apparently, Drake loves this heart, and he started a little trend. He's not the first kid that comes in or young man that comes in who wants a heart like Drake. They see that. They see Drake have a heart in his head, so they want the same thing. That's what happens with pop artists and hip-hop artists. They start trends and create trends. But I've been doing hearts in people's heads for so long. Drake took it. He liked it. Everybody liked it. And everybody wanted to see what Drake is, you know, like, hey, I want to get that heart also, like Drake is getting. So Drake continued to get this heart. So this wasn't a one haircut, one heart haircut. I don't know how long he's actually had it, but apparently through all of the photos that I've seen more than 5 or 6 photos. Apparently he's probably getting a haircut every week, right? But those haircuts, I mean, Drake is probably getting a haircut every week. So if he's getting a haircut every single week, it tells me a lot. It tells me I can literally say that you can't just cut a part away, that part has to grow back, right? And then you have to cut it back in. So apparently, if he's been wearing that heart back to back, I would guesstimate that he has had that heart in his head for probably 2 to 3 months. So he knows exactly what he's doing. He knows that, you know, he's capitalizing off of the fact that, hey, my barber put a fly heart in my head, and I watch all these kids get the same heart. And that's what's actually happened. That's what pop artists do. I mean, like, I remember years ago, Run DMC, like, they coined the Adidas. Everybody wore Adidas just because Run DMC was wearing shell-toe Adidas. Now, were they the creators of Adidas? No. But eventually, they started to, I believe they now own a portion of proceeds of Adidas because they made Adidas go to a whole nother level, right? And so they capitalize off of that. So I don't know. I don't know what made Drake put this heart. Maybe because he feels that he's a heartthrob, or he feels like, you know, he is the you know, maybe it's a thing where, you know, he's a ladies' man and he has to have a heart there. But it's all good with me because these haircuts allow us as barbers to also be a part of the trend, because everybody doesn't have access to Drake's barber, right? So they come into the barbershop and they say, hey, I want a Drake heart. And this is not the first time. I remember when I was younger, Big Daddy Kane had the flat top. Everybody wanted to get a flat top just like Big Daddy Kane. He had the little slash parts on the side. Everybody wanted to get the same parts. And me being a barber, I've seen trends come and go. Like, so this heart is, honestly, guys, this heart is not new. Maybe the position he had it, but I know I've cut several people many years ago who wanted a heart, a broken heart, on the top of their head, on the side of their head, around their head. But when Drake did it, it means a lot. And so that's the other reason what I really want to talk about, is that it really means a lot when a hip-hop artist, or when somebody who's really influential, when they come forward and they do a when they do something with how they dress and how they look, whether it's the haircut or whether it's the the certain look that they have, the certain flow that they have, they have these kids out here following them. And so I want to talk to all the hip-hop artists and all the guys who are doing big things. Use your influential power, use it as a way to influence some good. Use it as a way to influence. Now, I don't follow Drake like that, but I'm just saying, guys, like, you know, if you can get hundreds of thousands of kids to want a part like Drake, imagine what Drake can do if he says something to these kids, maybe in his music, or maybe just in not just in a song, but maybe in a speech or something, maybe in one of his lyrics or something like that, where he can say something to kind of get these kids to stay on the right road, stay on the right track. That is so important. Talk more about your music and how you're taking it to the next level. Talk more about how, you know, how you've changed so many other people's lives by giving them jobs. Talk about that. Talk about stuff that these kids gonna want to do when they get older. Like, tell them to stay in school, tell them to do what, you know, be obedient to their parents, you know, tell them to be productive. You know, that is the main key. And so I hope y'all like this heart. If you like this heart, like this video, like, subscribe, share. This is your boy, Super Barber Samson. Yo, Drake, come holla at your boy. I can give you a straight heart, a real heart. All right? Peace!
Let's go!